Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied about ionization enthalpy, in which we have got to know that ionization enthalpy is nothing but the energy required to remove the loosely bonded electron from an atom. But it will be nothing but the energy required to remove the electron from an ion also. So because on based on that basis, we are now going to declare that second ionization enthalpy is greater than first ionization enthalpy. How? Let us look at that. So now we are going to talk about the second ionization enthalpy is greater than the first ionization enthalpy. But before that, we should know that what is first ionization enthalpy. First ionization enthalpy is nothing but the ionization enthalpy itself that we have studied in our earlier lecture. But still on, let us see that what is first ionization enthalpy. So it is nothing but the energy required to remove the first electron from a gaseous atom of an element is called as first ionization enthalpy, as you could see. And it has been denoted by ionization enthalpy 1. We could represent in this way also, that is ionization enthalpy 1. And talking about the second one that we have, that is for second ionization enthalpy, and it says that the energy required to remove an electron from a singly positively charged gaseous cation, that is if we have to remove the second electron of an element, is called as second ionization enthalpy. Simple. So let me give you a small representation of this so as to understand what is first ionization enthalpy and what is second ionization enthalpy. Suppose if we have an atom named it as X, it is in a gaseous state, and in this case we have to remove an electron. So suppose if we have removed one electron, or the loosely bonded electron that was present in an atom, that is the outermost shell, so what I could say it as, electron has been removed. So because electron has been removed in this case, so what will happen, the positive charge will generate, and that would make now in this case the positive charge will be more in this case of the cation, that is the number of proton will be more than that of the number of electrons. So therefore this will turn into a X plus ion. So now the first electron, what we have removed, an electron from the atom. So this was the first electron that we have removed. That is the reason the ionization enthalpy, that is the delta H, can be represented as IE1. So this is the first electron that has been removed. And to remove the second electron, so we don't have to take again the cation or again the atom, and we have to remove two electrons. So the thing is, what we can do is, once we have removed this electron from the atom so as to convert into singly positive charge cation, so in this case what we are going to do, we are going to abstract one more electron from the X plus ion, or which is singly charged cation. So in this case what we are going to do is, we are going to remove another electron. So if we have removed one electron in this case, so the number of positively charged species, that is what we are talking about, will be more. So the number of positive charge on the ion will now be more. Now it was earlier 1, now it will be having overall 2 plus charge. So because of removing one electron. So again this kind of process will go on, this process or this kind of ionization will go on so as to remove the electrons. But this second electron that we have removed, or this process of removing the second electron, is known as second ionization, and the energy required to remove this second electron is known as ionization enthalpy 2, or second ionization enthalpy. It's very easy to understand. But this is what we have understood, that is what is first ionization enthalpy and what is second ionization enthalpy. But there is a comparison that the second ionization enthalpy is always more or greater than that of first ionization enthalpy. Why? That is what I want to explain. So suppose if we have an atom named it as X, so therefore suppose this will have number of multiple shells, and in which the electron has been present here over here, as you could see. There will be multiple electrons in the orbit, as you know. So suppose if this is the loosely bonded electron, so therefore the energy that I will require to remove this electron So once I remove this electron, so what will happen? The positive charge will increase. So basically now in this case, what I'm doing is, I'm converting basically X into, which is in a gaseous state, X into X plus ion by removing one electron. So now by after removing one electron, the energy that was spent, it was ionization enthalpy 1. But as we could see, because of the nuclear charge, as we could see here also, because this was the loosely held electron and this was the nucleus. So therefore, the distance was more in this case, as we could see. So therefore, if the distance is more, then we could say as the nuclear charge will be less, and the nuclear charge, if it will be less, then the atomic size will be more. So in this case, what happens is, because of the nuclear charge is very much less, so it would be very much easy for us to remove this electron. So if this electron is been removed by naming the ionization enthalpy as first ionization enthalpy. Now suppose in this case, suppose if we have to remove the second electron, so the second electron can be in this orbit also, or can be in the lower orbit also. So suppose if the electron is been present in the first orbit itself, or it can be in the second orbit. So if we have to remove the second electron, which has been present in this case, and we have to remove the second electron. So what is the thing? The second, by removing the second electron, the ionization enthalpy would be termed as basically the second ionization enthalpy. But in this case, what will happen? The energy required in this case would be more. Why? Because earlier what we had did, we have converted the X into X plus ion, and now what we are going to do is, we are converting X plus ion into X 2 plus ion, which has two positive charge. So initially, suppose by removing this electron, it had a positive charge acquired by the atom. Or we could say as the number of protons was more in compared to that of the number of electrons. So now in this case, by removing one electron, so what will happen? The positive charge will go on increasing, and for that, suppose if we have to remove the second electron, so while removing the second electron, so in this case what will happen is, the nuclear charge will be more, and the effect of the nuclear charge will be more for removing the second electron. So that is the reason we have to need more energy so as to remove this electrons from the influence of the nuclear charge. So that is the reason to remove the second electron we require higher energy. So that is the reason the second ionization enthalpy is always greater than the first ionization enthalpy, and it will go on continuing. So this will make a proper statement from us that always, suppose if we have third ionization enthalpy, will be always greater than second ionization enthalpy, and second ionization enthalpy will be greater than the first ionization enthalpy. So this is all related to the nuclear charge as well as the atomic size, and moreover the loosely bonded electrons. So in case of the first ionization enthalpy, it is always dedicated towards the loosely bonded electrons, which is present in the outermost shell, and we have to remove that electron. While talking about the second electron, because of which, if we have to remove the second loosely bonded electron, so that means that the nuclear charge has been increased, or there will be more effective nuclear charge that can be also led to the decrease in the atomic size or ionic size, which will lead to more energy required so as to remove the second electron, and it will move on third, fourth and on. So this made a statement that the second ionization enthalpy is always greater than the first ionization enthalpy. For an example, again I will give you an example. So for example, like sodium has the outermost electron, that is one, and to remove that electron it would be easy, but to remove the second electron, which is present in the innermost shell, it would require more energy, because this was the loosely bonded electrons, and hence it was called to be the first ionization enthalpy. While to remove this electron, that is 8 electrons which are present in the second shell, and to remove that electron, it would be a very much difficult task, because in that case, when the one electron has been removed, so the last electron, that is on the second shell itself, and in this case the nuclear charge will be more because the distance has been reduced. And if the nuclear charge is more, obviously more energy would be required to remove that from the influence of the nucleus or the nuclear charge that we know. So that's the reason second ionization enthalpy is greater than the first ionization enthalpy. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you understood this video very much clearly, and share this video with your friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to EKEDA channel. Thank you so much.